fun, fantastic, and interesting.
Why those two?
It was a fun season. Going out to Commonwealth game, Gold Coast, that was a bit of fun. Obviously, we started the season quite early on, so it was one of those things that you never know really how to expect to go, and it ended up being a good championship, we have a gold medal. It's fantastic because obviously Europeans, sort of, you know, icing on the cake in terms of both relay teams doing really well. I've just always got that picture in my head where the squad's, you know, got eight athletes, you know, just buzzing with smiles. It just kind of does well to show how much depth we have. And I'd say interesting just purely because I found it difficult in a sense trying to beat certain champs and where the Commonwealth games were so early, and it was just an interesting format in regards to things and how I would try and move forward. But you know, it was still a good season. Building from 2018 to 2019 is an interesting one, just more so Doha World Champ September to October. How do you deal with that? But you know, everyone's got to deal with the same problem. If it's a problem, or just, you know, just the factor of what it is. I mean, got a bit more confidence, got a bit more belief in myself in regards to moving forward. So yeah, it's just about moving forward with that and just keeping faith and keep believing in yourself. I mean, most importantly is your coach. You know, you liaise and talk with that person the majority of the time. Benke's got his head screwed on really, really well. You got to believe in them, you got to have that faith in them. You know, I've got my physio, Jazz, over at Edgebaston Performance Clinic. He's, you know, integral in that, you know, making sure that I'm moving well. As well as Megan Dixon as well. These people, I think that you've got to be able to have a lot of trust in and being able to, you know, talk about any issues, any problems, whether it be private life, whether it be, you know, part of track life. You're just finding a way to be able to be comfortable with everything you do. Obviously, you've got your friends and your family. Training groups are a massive aspect of that as well, because obviously you're motivating each other, pushing each other forward, and just these are people you're around every day. So I mean, you take it with a pinch of salt because you know you do it every day, but at the same time everyone's integral to that sort of big chain, that big clock. So I mean, just hoping that we can all help each other move forward. How proud of my family? I don't know, it's one of the things that you don't really appreciate until maybe they're in front of someone else, or because you're never there when that moment happens where you do get a medal or you do achieve something. You're not with them, you're at the track. So obviously they tell you how happy they are, but I think it's more so when I see my dad explaining to his friends, or he's on the phone telling people about, like, you know, family back in Ghana or wherever around the world, you know, what I've been up to, and you know, then you sort of get the idea of how proud they are. My parents are quite humble, they don't want me to get too, I've never gotten too big for my boots. I think I remember from way back when, I think it was when I first won my world, when I won like first major title, like World Youths or something. I think I got home, I still had to do the washing up pretty much the same day. So they've always been that way inclined. It's never been, yeah, like, you know, allow me to have a big head. But yeah, just an integral part of that. Typical day, depends. Normally, if a typical day in Loughborough, a typical Monday, let's say, would be start training at 9:30. So I'm up at 8. You get your breakfast in. Can be anything from like 2 eggs and a bagel with a coffee to a green tea. And then, yeah, training wise, if we're looking at a block session, it's quite a while. So warm ups, like you have your drills, your activation, all sorts. So basically a track session can be up to 2 to 3 hours once you're done. And then yeah, sorting out your lunch, making sure you get that recovery in. And you're done by 2. I'm at home, chilling, relaxing, which is key, because obviously you're an athlete for 24 hours of the day. So as much as I'd love to go off and gallivant around the country doing certain things with my friends and family, it wouldn't be ideal for the next day, so you do have to sort of put yourself in bubble wrap. So half the time I'm sat on my sofa playing FIFA. Just that belief to know that I haven't achieved everything I want to achieve, just the belief in knowing that I've still got more to give and knowing that I haven't reached my full potential. I've been around a while now, people can actually say that. I think I made my first GB senior team, Europa Cup in 2006. So yeah, I've been around a little while, so that's fair enough to say. It's interesting because obviously I remember when people said I've been around the world from, you know, 2013, and I didn't really feel like I had, but now I think you can say that. I want people to remember me as being that an inspirational character, to be fair. Someone that never gave up, someone that always saw the light when it was dark, someone who always wanted to inspire people around him as well as motivate himself.